गुड मॉर्निंग स्टैंडर्ड फाइव स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे इन दिस क्लास विल स्टार्ट सॉल्युबिलिटी ऑफ सब्सटेंसेस इन लिक्विड्स। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द सॉल्युबिलिटी ऑफ सब्सटेंसेस इन लिक्विड्स। सो व्हाट इज सॉल्युबिलिटी, फर्स्ट वी विल नो। सॉल्युबिलिटी इज द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ ए सॉलिड, लिक्विड और गैसियस केमिकल सब्सटेंसेस टू डिजॉल्व इन सम अदर सब्सटेंसेस टू फॉर्म ए मिक्सचर ऑफ यूनिफॉर्म नेचर। दैट मीन्स सॉल्युबिलिटी मीन्स द प्रॉपर्टी दैट वन सब्सटेंस डिजॉल्व इन अदर सब्सटेंस। So solubility is defined as the maximum amount of a substance that will dissolve in a given amount of solvent at a specified temperature. So it is a amount of substance that will dissolve in a fixed amount of solvent also at a specified temperature. That means by changing the temperature, the solubility also can change. Now you can see in this picture also it is shown solid, gas and liquid, how it is defined. Solubility of a substance is its maximum amount that can be dissolved in a specified amount of solvent. That means maximum amount of substance that can dissolve in a fixed amount of solvent also. That is known as solubility. And you can see in this picture also, in this a measure of how much solute can dissolve in a solvent at a given temperature. So let us know about the solvent and solute also. What is a solvent? A substance that dissolves another substance. That means a substance which dissolves the other substance like water. If you will put salt in the water will dissolve the salt in it. That means water is a solvent here. Now what is a solute? Salt is the solute. The part of a solution present when a solid dissolves in a solvent, then it forms a solution. The part of a solution present in a lesser amount and dissolved by the solvent is called solute. That means if salt is dissolved by the water, salt is here solute and water is solvent. Now you know that water is known as the universal solvent. Why it is known as universal solvent? Because most of the substances readily dissolve in water. That is why it is known as the universal solvent. You know in daily life also most of the substances we are using in our houses, they are dissolving in water only, like salt, sugar, our all the things we are making in water only. Milk is also dissolving in water only. Washing powder is also dissolved in water only. So all these things we dissolve in water only. Water is very good solvent. Many liquids, solids and gases dissolve in water. Not only solid but liquid and gases also dissolve in water. It is capable of dissolving more substances than any other liquid. That's why it is an universal solvent. Now, more thing you have to know about this solubility. Soluble and insoluble, these two terms are also very important. So let us know about the soluble and insoluble. So soluble and insoluble substances, a substance that dissolves in a solvent. That means if a substance is dissolved, it is mixed and disappears in the solvent, then it is known as soluble substance. Insoluble substance is that a substance that does not dissolve in a solvent. Like sand, sand is insoluble. Sand is insoluble in water. It will settle at the bottom of the container. That means it is insoluble. But salt and sugar, if you will mix in the water, it will disappear. That means it dissolves in water. So it is soluble. Solute and solvent, we have discussed earlier. Solute and solvent, let us see about the solute and solvent. When one substance dissolves into another, if you are dissolving any substance in another substance, a solution is formed. A solution is a homogeneous mixture consisting of a solute dissolved into a solvent. It is a mixture of solute and solvent, that is solution. The solute is the substance that is being dissolved. That means if salt we will dissolve in water, the salt will be solid because it disappears in the water. That means it is being dissolved in the water. And while the solvent is the dissolving medium, that means water is the medium in which the salt dissolves. So water is the solvent in this case. You can see here solute, solid given, solvent, liquid, the solute dissolves in it, and solution, there is a mixture of solute and solvent. Now solids in water, how solids dissolve in water? Substances like sugar and salt are soluble in water. If we add a spoonful of sugar to a glass of water, The sugar dissolve in the water to form a solution. That means sugar disappears. When we make a sugar syrup, we dissolve sugar in water. So that means sugar is a solid that dissolves in water to form a solution of sugar and water. All solids do not dissolve in water. Solids like sand particles and chalk powder settle down at the bottom of the container. They will make a separate layer at the bottom. That means they do not disappear when we dissolve them in the water. That means they are insoluble. They cannot make the solution of water and sand. Now some liquids are also completely dissolving in water and some are not dissolved. That is miscible and immiscible liquids. Two liquids that completely dissolve in each other are called miscible liquids, like alcohol and water, milk and water. Two liquids that are not miscible in each other are called immiscible liquids, like oil and water. Oil layer, you can see the picture also showing. The oil layer will be shown separately when we will mix oil in the water. That means they are not dissolving in each other. They are not mixing in each other. That's why they are known as immiscible liquids. Polar water and non-polar oil are immiscible liquids and do not mix to form a solution. You can see here the oil is forming a separate layer in the water. What is the difference between miscible liquids and immiscible liquids? Liquids which mix together in all proportion and form a single layer are called miscible. They form a single layer. You cannot separate them after mixing. But immiscible liquids do not mix with each other and form separate layers are called immiscible liquids. They form separate layers because they don't mix with each other. They are separated by the process of fractional distillation. We can separate the liquids, miscible liquids, by fractional distillation. But immiscible liquids are separated by using separating funnel. We use a separating funnel to separate immiscible liquids. In this picture, it is very clear. You can see liquid A and liquid B. Liquid A and liquid B, they are here shown. They are non-miscible. That's why you can see the separate layer of liquid A and liquid B in this picture. Liquid A has a separate and liquid B is separate. Now in this you can see oil in water, water in oil. Whether you will take oil in water or water in oil, they will not mix. They will form a separate layer, you can see in this picture. Here oil is forming here, and again when we will mix this, then again oil will come above and water will go down, and they will form the separate layer because oil is lighter than the water. So always oil will float over the water. And they will form a separate layer because oil and water are immiscible liquids. Liquids in water. Some liquids like glycerin and alcohol dissolve in water to form solutions. When two liquids dissolve in each other, they are said to be miscible. Now, if we try to mix oil and water, they do not mix with each other. Oil and water are immiscible liquids. I have shown already in the picture before. Now gases in water. Some gases like carbon dioxide, oxygen and ammonia mix in water. Water plants and fish breathe with the oxygen dissolved in water. The fizz in the colas we drink is actually dissolved carbon dioxide. When we open the cap of the fish drinks, then what we see? We see the bubbles. The bubbles of carbon dioxide come out because they are compressed in the bottle with high pressure. When we release the pressure by opening the cap of the bottle, the carbon dioxide bubbles are coming out. Aquatic plants take dissolved carbon dioxide in water to make their food. That means that dissolved gases, carbon dioxide and oxygen are very important for the survival of the living things. Carbon dioxide is taken by the aquatic plants to make their food, and oxygen is taken by plants and animals living in the water for breathing. So they survive with the help of dissolved carbon dioxide and oxygen in the water. Without that, their life is not possible in the water. You can see in this picture, aquatic plants and animals, they survive with the oxygen and carbon dioxide dissolved in the water, and they are very important for their life. Now, thank you, students. We will meet in the next class again for the next session. Thank you, all of you.